Hey everybody, and welcome back to the MacWhisperer Academy. I'm Dylan Stewart, the MacWhisperer. If you've ever gotten one of those notices from Safari or on your phone that tells you that your passwords have been compromised, then this lesson today is just for you. Let's get started. Passwords used to be so simple. You didn't need a capital letter. You didn't need a number or a symbol. You could use the same password for everything. Ha! Those were the good old days, back before hacking was a term that even your grandmother knew about. Before thieves had these sophisticated tools that would allow them to break into your passwords and test that password on every known website out there. Which brings us to the compromised password warnings we keep getting. Why are you seeing that warning? Well, it can happen for a number of reasons. One of the reasons could be that that particular website got hacked and they reported it and Apple is letting you know. That happens. But the more common reason that it happens is because you're using the same password on tons and tons of sites and one of them got hacked. Which means that every other one that's using that same password has now been compromised. Which means two things. We just can't use the same password on every site anymore. And we have to start to use more complex passwords. The first thing I want to talk about in today's video is how to create a smart password. First thing we want to understand is that most websites use the same criteria for passwords. A minimum of 8 characters. At least one capital letter, and at least one number. There's a few websites that require a symbol, and a few websites that can't use a symbol. So what I recommend is starting with what I'll call a base password. The base password can be anything. You want it to be a word that you can remember, or even two words that don't generally go together, like fuzzy lemon or slimy horse. Or one word that's completely meaningless except to you, like gooblad or zing-zang. So pick your word, pick your base word. For the example here, I'm gonna use fuzzy lemon because why not? It's simple, it's easy, I can remember it. So once you've got your base password figured out, we need to turn our attention to what number we're gonna use. I recommend using a number that can change, like the year, or your age, or your children's age, basically any random number you can update without throwing the entire system into chaos. Once you have your base word and your number, we're ready for the next step. For me, I'm gonna use fuzzylemon22. So what I propose for this system is rather than having a completely unique password for every single website, that you create your base password and you add on an identifying feature from each website. For example, maybe you're going to use the first two letters of the website, or the last two letters, or the first letter and the last letter, or the first three letters. It doesn't matter. But whatever you decide to use, keep it consistent. I've seen a lot of clients that use the first two letters on this site and the last two letters on that site, and then random letters in the middle of some other site. That doesn't work. You're going to have to create a consistent system. You take those letters and you add them to your base word and number. If I was using fuzzylemon22 and I'm creating a password for Google, I could take the G-O-O or the G-O or the G and the E from the end. So let's do that. Let's take the G and the E from the end. Now, where do I put them within fuzzylemon? Anywhere you want. You could put G-E fuzzylemon or fuzzylemon G-E or fuzzy G-E lemon. It really doesn't matter. As long as you keep it consistent. So if my base password was fuzzylemon22 and I choose to use the first two letters, my Google password would be G-O fuzzylemon22. And my Amazon password would be A-M fuzzylemon22. And if you're watching this and thinking that I've just given you my password, don't bother trying that password. It won't work. I'm just using it as an example. I'm not that dumb. So let's assume that you've got your password system set up now. You know how you're going to do it. You know what your base word is. You know what letters you're going to pull for which websites. But that's only part of the problem. Because now you're going to have all these passwords, and where are you going to store them? I know. You're thinking, it's a simple system, Dylan. I'm going to remember them. But let's be honest, you won't. How do I know? I've been doing this for 20 years. I've been teaching systems like this for 20 years, and I still have clients call me, asking what their password is all the time. So even with a system this simple, there will be exceptions, and those exceptions will cause problems. So whatever you do, we need some place to put the passwords. Some people put them in a physical notebook. They keep that notebook near their desk, and they say, this is a perfect system because it can't be hacked, and it's great as long as you're always near your desk when you need a password, which is not going to happen as often as you think. You're going to be out and about, and you're going to be on your phone, and you're going to be trying to log into Instagram or prompted for your Apple password, and you're not going to know what it is. So you're going to guess, and you're going to guess wrong. And then you're going to have to reset it. And then you're going to forget what you reset it to. And then you're going to forget to write it down in the book. And then the whole system falls apart, and it starts back over again. Trust me, in 20 years of computer work, I've seen it happen time and time again. The people who have those physical notebooks for the passwords are the ones that spend the most money on me figuring out how to log them into sites that they thought they had the password for. Some people have chosen to put all their passwords in their computer's address book. Theoretically, it's smart because it's searchable, but it's really a terrible place to put them. Why? Well, first of all, that's not where your passwords belong. It creates its own issues. If your phone or anything gets stolen, that's the first place a thief is going to look. And on top of that, it clutters up your address book, which means that your address book doesn't work properly, Siri doesn't find things properly, and when you're looking up people's names, you stumble across all of these websites and all these passwords that just don't belong there. It's just not an effective system. So in a moment, we're going to talk about a password management program that's really my recommendation for all of my clients. But some clients don't want to spend the money or learn a password management program. So for those people, I recommend using Apple's Notes. Let me open up a note for us here. For those of you that have been watching my videos, you know that I am a fanatic for Apple Notes. I use it all the time and for tons of different reasons. This is one of the suggestions I make for a lot of my clients to keep it simple. Forget about having that notepad. Forget about using Microsoft Word or Microsoft Excel. Forget about putting it in your address book. Just put it in Notes. You can start off by creating a blank note, and I recommend calling it something other than passwords, just for simplicity. I like the word elephant. It's the elephant in the room. You can use whatever you want to use. Just remember that's where your passwords are. And then, using that note, you write down the websites in alphabetical order with their password. So it would look like this, Amazon, and then I'm going to put in my username. And I know you're thinking to yourself, I know what username it is. Don't make that assumption. Make it simple for yourself. Now, for most websites, your username is your email address, but there's a handful of them that don't work that way. Ones like financial sites, credit card sites, and banks that don't use an email as your username. So don't get yourself confused by not writing down your username. And then I go on to the next website. So I recommend just keeping it simple, keeping it alphabetical, and keeping it organized. Some people will say to me, well, what if your phone gets stolen? But hopefully you're using a passcode or Touch ID or Face ID to protect your phone number. But if you really want to secure your password note, you can padlock it by clicking up here and locking it, and giving it its own password. But don't forget that password, or you'll end up locking yourself out. So Notes is a pretty decent place to put your passwords, but in my book, there's still a better way to do it, and that's a password management system. What makes a password management program smart is that not only does it give you a place to store and organize all of your passwords, but when you open up a website, it automatically enters in the password so you don't have to remember it and you don't have to look it up. When you change your password on a website, the password management program prompts you to update your system with the new password. And a good password management program will work from your phone, your iPad, your computer, the web, basically anywhere that you might be where you might need access to your password. These programs are all heavily encrypted and keep your data extremely safe. Many of them will also give you a location for credit cards and other autofill information that makes them even easier when you use them. It's definitely not necessary to use a password management system, but for me, it simplifies things significantly. I'm gonna tell you a little story. I had been using a password management program for about 10 years, but earlier this year, they decided to go away from using a local application and go to only using a web app for their password management program. I did my best to use their web app. I really tried. I had a ton of clients that were using this software, and I went ahead and I converted all of the clients to the web app version of the software, but I really didn't like it. I was really unhappy with it. So I set out to find a better password management program. And after 2 months of testing every single password management program out there, I came across one called Roboform. So I tried it and I liked it. It was simple, it was clean, it was easy to use. I turned all of my clients onto Roboform, and Roboform reached out to me and said, "We notice you're sending a lot of people to our site. Is there anything we can do for you?" So Roboform gave me my own discount code, and it's in the description down below. If you do choose to use Roboform, you do choose to click that link, I get a kickback from them for sending them business. But I'll tell you, I would be using Roboform anyways. I will be recommending it whether you do or don't choose to use it. I'm not saying you need to use a password management program. You can do anything you want to do. You can use any of the systems that we've talked about. But for me and my clients, I do recommend a password program, and I do recommend Roboform. Roboform is not the only password manager out there. There are dozens. There's 1Password, there's Dashlane, there's Apple's own Keychain, and many, many more. So you can pick literally any of these to get the job done. But whatever you choose to do, whatever password system you decide to create, keep it simple. The complex systems don't keep out the hackers. More often than not, they keep you out. So if you like this video and you got a lot of value out of it, hit that thumbs up button. And if you would like to see more videos like this, subscribe to my channel. I release new videos regularly with Apple tips, walkthroughs, hints, tricks, and much, much more so that you can always get more done in less time and with less effort than you ever thought possible. And if you'd like to help me out by signing up for Roboform through my link, you'll get a 30% discount by using the code you see in the description. At any rate, I'm Dylan Stewart. I'm the Mac Whisperer, and I can't wait to see you next time.